Hi there, my name is Aparna. I'm a coach. Every week I bring to you tips, tricks, tools and hacks that can help you upskill your life. And if this interests you, do consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and following me on various social media handles that are flashing on the screen and will also be given in the description below. I am in a mood to normalize failure, and I set the context to that in my previous video. I'm going to be talking about failures, failure stories, and introducing you to some amazing people who have failed big in their lives. Our failures teach us a lot, but we can also learn from others' failures. With that intention, I kickstart the series today by introducing you to one of my friends, Shrikant Madge, who is an experimentalist, has a diverse background, and an incredible zest for life. Shrikant, welcome to my channel.
Thanks, Aparna. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for giving us your time and also the willingness. Appreciate the willingness to share your failures with all of us. So I want to start today by asking you to share this experimentalist streak within you, and if you can also share some adventures as well.
I think that experimentalist nature, and that, thanks for giving that title to me, came from starting with nowhere. Right. I started my life as a son of a farmer and an educational employee. My mom was a lecturer. Coming from a small town, I always wanted to do something larger than life, but didn't know what to do. So I did my engineering while I was still doing farming with my father from a small town near Amravati. Then I migrated to Pune, Mumbai. Then I moved to Singapore. Then I went to US. Had a good illustrious career in IT. Right. My boss, when I was in New York City, helped me to become a postgraduate. He helped me to do MBA in IT from University of Phoenix. He sponsored it. But somehow, somewhere that inner calling was always missing. Then I realized I was working in a building which was facing West 4th Street, that is a New York Stock Exchange. So I started trading and did some adventures there. Within 13 or 14 days, I lost almost $1,000, $1,000. That was the first failure I can recall immediately. I stopped doing it. Then I continued with my main career, that was IT. And then suddenly, when I was doing my MBA, I came across these financial topics. And then I got literate in my finances and I started stock trading again. Came back to India, then I had a good career in good Indian IT companies. But somehow this inner calling was always missing. So I took a first risk and quit the job. That was the time when I know so many people care about me.
How many years into the career did you...
Almost like 20 years had passed till then. And the funny part was, I came to know how many people care about me because the people I don't even knew, they were coming and giving me the advice. What you have done? Are you stupid? Right? But fortunately, my family was always with me. I said, I will do farming because I'm a farmer. So I bought a farm, did farming for 2 years. It didn't work out. Right? I was deceived a lot. Right. When I was not there, people were stealing the farm produce. They were breaking into the house that I had there. They were, making my people laborers that I used to bring and migrate them from other places there to chase them off. So I quit farming. That was the second failure in my life. Then I was very good at photography. I'm still at good at photography. So I did a wedding photography and, product photography. So the money coming out of the photography was very near. It was just meeting my needs. I said, this is not good for me. So that was the third failure for me. So after experimenting with life in 3 projects and coming out failure, somehow it was like, roads were looking a little blurry and didn't have much, sight out of the window. But then one fine day I realized, without putting an attention to anything, I'm still into the financial market. I was doing a lot of investments, a lot of trading and other things. So it's like you have a crush on a lot of young girls in the college and you keep getting failure and failure. Then you realize the girl sitting next to your bench is your sweetheart, right? And you never, paid attention to her.
Wonderful.
Exactly. So same thing really happened. I was doing financial analysis. I was doing financial services. I was doing financial advices and other things for me and my friend. I said, this is the hidden treasure I had. And I was looking around the places for it. I think experiment is one word, but really falling in love with the challenges, the failures, and having that confidence, failures are part of life. And if you take them in your stride, life can be easy and more rewarding.
I agree. All of us know about this, right? We all know that success comes after the failure. But the focus of this particular discussion, I want to keep on how do we manage ourselves when we are undergoing the failure, the emotions that are connecting that failure. The series per se is to help people get ideas on what they can do if they are in a situation similar to you. Before we get there, I wanted to understand your story on your greatest failure, something that has broken you down, something that has shattered you. Can you share that?
So after I came into this financial full-time work that I was mentioning, the third endeavor that I was doing, I was making small money with my own wisdom. I was hearing stories of lot of, you know, uneven successes that people were achieving. And I got lured by it. And I started to take somebody else's advice to do something in financial world, in the trading world, for example. And it backfired. It backfired, but it didn't backfire in one day. It started a trickling effort. And whatever sizable corpus, financial corpus I had allocated for my this business, evaporated in a matter of 13 days. That was a big corpus. Big corpus which can put anybody in desperation. The first thought came to my mind was shut down everything, go on a wild tour somewhere. The dictionary word is run away from something.
Yeah, that is the adventurer in you speaking.
But after 15-20 minutes went up, when I saw that big red on my balance sheet, I said, it was your greed that has made this disaster. But it's not only you who are involved in this everything. You have your upper umbrella, that is the parents, those who are looking after you. You are your downward channel that is dependent on you. Your absenteeism, your running away is not going to make them only look down, but it is also going to make you exactly the anti of what you are. Whoever knows me knows that I am experimentalist. The first thing came is that my reputation is at the stake and man is known by his reputation, right? First feedback was, how can I correct my mistake? The loss has happened. This failure has happened because of my mistake. Then why should I blame or make other people suffer? I will be committing two mistakes. The one mistake that I already done up, and then hiding and running away is going to be another mistake, right? So, and again, as I said, these are not the only failure. Failure keep coming up. But for me, failure is nothing but an opportunity to learn. And that is a very dictionary word that you will find out everywhere. But literally, I do it. Okay, I did some mistakes. With maturity or as experience is coming up, the only thing is happening is that whenever I experiment now, I experiment with protection. Right? When whatever I do now, failure are givens. They are going to happen. They are part of the life. But now when I fall, I don't fall off on the face. I have some cushion. I don't do anything in secrecy. So that my family, all my people who are involved with me know what I'm doing. So there is no shame or a surprise to them.
Yeah, so I'm interested in staying in the part where you fell down, okay? And the reason I'm coming back repeatedly to this point is because with your experience and wisdom, you are able to learn from it. But there are several people out there who do not understand that this is a stepping stone or that it is teaching you something. So going back to your story, can you think about the emotions that you were going through when this happened to you?
So that feeling of helplessness. What failure means you are not able to do anything. That was very uncomfortable for me. My first emotion was, how can this happen to me? This cannot happen to me and I have to correct it. I think it is a personality style or whatever you can call it. Accepting what comes to me is not acceptable to me. I want to be in control. Not controlling people, but I want to be in control of what is happening to me. I wanted to change it desperately. It was not about the money, right? The inner force that was driving me to get up was, I want to change it in my favor. The word that you use, right? What made you change the downward path and turn back and start coming up? I want to change what has happened to me, right? I don't want it to call myself as a victim of what has happened to me. That victim word was very uncomfortable. I talk to people around. They are victims. They say, oh, stock market is very bad. I lost so many things. They are stuck to that failure. They are accepted to be a victim. I was not ready to accept myself as a victim. And that denial to be a victim was the driving force to get up, correct the mistake that I had done, right? Which was lack of knowledge. Get the knowledge and start the journey back.
You raised a very pertinent point, Srikant, and I want to thank you for that. Feeling like a victim can be dangerous, right? It can lead to self-pity and further damage us emotionally as well. And this is the point where support is crucial, right? The kind of people who are surrounding you and how they either push you down or pull you up. And I believe that this is a vulnerable state. So whether they are having that kind of a support or not, because I know not many people are privileged. So what do you think that they can do to manage themselves when they are in that vulnerable state?
This particular failure, the one aspect that make me wake up is my duty towards the, you know, stakeholders in my life.
The responsibility, you're saying.
Responsibility. right? If not me, and if not now, then who and when? So if I exactly want to pinpoint the feeling I had in that 30 seconds or 60 seconds when I saw that event happening, right, was somebody is looking at me. Their entire life depends upon what picture they see now. If they see their caretaker, their father, their shield, victimized, wounded and broken, I will regain myself again. But the image that is going to live on their brain for a long time may not be correctable. It depends upon what is your pivot, what is your, you know, comparison point you're talking about. All these are our relative factors. One failure for somebody can commit a suicide. Other person may not even notice that failure.
Great. Thank you so very much, Srikanth. I truly appreciate what you shared with us so far about your failures, about your journey, and how you have handled your greatest failure. I'm sure that our viewers are learning from it. But before I end today, before I let you go, I'd like to ask you one last question. Is there any message you'd like to give to people who are watching you today?
The one underlying principle that I think my entire journey so far has been based is successful people never quit. And if you love what you are doing, there is no reason for quitting. Struggle and failures are obvious. If you fail, you have not done any big sin. You have been obvious. But if you fail consistently and then one day you become successful, that is the abnormal thing. That is the things to celebrate. Don't worry about failures. Those are obvious. It has happened with me. It will happen with me. It has happened with you. It will definitely again happen with you. Just like day and night is obvious, success and failure both are obvious. Mr. Amitabh Bachchan says that which lasts long is not easily got. That which easily got does not last long. So intensity of success will increase multifold if it is preceded by failures. Whenever you fail, just prepare yourself for a big party, because the intensity of success, the joy is going to be very high when eventually you will succeed.
That was wonderful. Thanks again, Srikanth. I can't appreciate enough. To our viewers here, if you're going through any kind of financial failures, please reach out to Srikanth. He works in that space and can also help you overcome your financial troubles. And if you're going through any kind of life issues, comment in the description below, or you can reach out to me in any of the social media platforms that I'm in. If you like this video, hit the like button, share it with your friends, and I'll see you next week with another failure story. Until then, take good care of yourself. Bye.